I really don't understand.
I know.
Why it hasn't occurred to you already.
It has.
That the problem with these sorts of arguments.
The problem in your head is one of your ignorance of the subject.
Is the fact that every single religion on the planet has people who claim to have personal experience that validates their religion.
And with good reason. You see, these false religions, they really have deities. God threw one third of the angels out of heaven for their pride. The same kind of pride that you have, your humanist pride, which prevents you from acknowledging your creator. You could have a relationship with one of these false deities if you like. I don't advise it. But if you're an ardent God denialist, in a way you already do. Because your mind is partially controlled by them anyway.
Again, this goes back to the same principle that if somebody can take an argument just like yours and swap out the God that's being talked about and use it against you, and you wouldn't be convinced.
Oh, I'm quite convinced. You see, I've studied this subject intensively. In fact, I've got that little supernatural wisdom from God that only Christians get, you know. We've got something you don't have. Boo!
It's probably not a good argument for you to be making.
I don't make arguments. I just tell the truth.
If somebody comes along and they say that they have a burning in their bosom that tells them that they know, they're certain, they have an absolute inner conviction that Mormonism is true or that Islam is true or that the flying spaghetti monster is true, you would dismiss them out of hand.
I would dismiss that they have a relationship with Jesus Christ, not that they have a relationship with some entity.
And yet at the same time, you expect us to believe you.
No, I don't expect you to believe. For sure. And I don't expect everyone to believe. Because, you know, that's just not the way it's going to be. Even God told us that. I mean, in His written word. But I do expect people who have an open mind, an open heart to the truth, to pay attention and to seek knowledge and to find out if what I say is the truth. Unfortunately, most ardent atheists won't do that. And even if you present them with a tremendous mountain of evidence, they say, "Remember, there is no evidence of God." Remember that old "no evidence" thing. You can stack it up, the Coke cans all over the floor. "I don't see no Coke cans. What Coke cans are you talking about? Ain't no Coke cans in here." See, that's what I don't expect people to get over. If they're ardent atheists, if their heart is not open to the truth, you know, if they're so diametrically opposed to God, no, I don't expect that. And anybody who, you know, follows a false God, has a false religion, I would not expect them to convert either. You can't expect anybody to convert. You can only present them with the information, with the knowledge. And then, if they're going to, they will. If they won't, they won't, you know. God has told us, not everyone is going to follow Him. In fact, some people who do believe in Him, they're not going to see God either. Jesus said, some will say, "Lord, Lord." Not everyone who says, "Lord, Lord," will see the kingdom of God. It depends on what's in your heart. If you're repentive toward God, if you're humble to God, if you will work with God when He works in your heart to change you, if you're receptive to His admonition for your sin, and His love when He shares it and gives it, the strength and courage that He gives you, if you're receptive to those things, God will draw you and lead you and teach you and change you and enlighten you. But not everyone is willing.
To believe you and to not dismiss you out of hand, you don't see any hypocrisy there?
No, there's no hypocrisy. There's simply a problem in your mind caused by your ignorance of the subject and your unwillingness to accept or acknowledge that there is a supernatural realm. Perhaps that's something you should think about the next time you watch your Lord of the Rings DVD.
No, NephilimFree, it's perfectly possible. What you're describing is a psychological experience.
You mean these hundreds of miracles that occur in the world every day, in churches and in people's homes and on the streets? These are just imaginary? You mean when all these people in these churches around the world, in Africa and the United States and the UK and everywhere, in Russia, the Ukraine. You mean when these people are praying over people with illnesses and they put their hands on them and they pray and they feel the power of God come under them and all of a sudden they're able to walk again, or the macular degeneration is cured, or diabetic distal neuropathy is cured, or cancer is cured? All those events are just the result of some feel-good sensation? Having a really good song on the radio or something? Or like my best friend over here, Sharon. Sharon, say hello.
Hello.
My friend Sharon there, who had God speak to her and said, tell him to put his hands on your feet and pray and I'll take the pain away. She had suffered with diabetic distal neuropathy for years, constant and non-ending pain 24/7. And so I did. I got on my knees and I put my hands on her feet and I prayed. And I only said two words, my king. And boom, she felt icicles shoot out of her toes. You mean, and the sheathing around her nerves, which is cannot be regenerated, is incurable. It grew back instantaneously, and she hasn't had a single pain since. And she's been cured of diabetic distal neuropathy. You mean that was just imaginary? Wow. Oh, by the way, that imaginary experience that the two of us had with God, where she was cured of distal neuropathy instantaneously, that was 2 years ago. She hadn't had a pain since. No, I know what you're thinking. The body cannot cure this. The sheathing around the nerves, when it degenerates, it's gone. It's non-regenerative material. It will not grow back. But that was imaginary. We imagined all that. Maybe we were under the same delusion that 2.1 billion Christians are at the same time. Well, this little cult of atheists around the world,
we got the truth, oh, we know the truth, yeah, we got the truth.
It's sort of like you saying, you know, if you ever truly fell in love with somebody and you knew that that person was perfect for you and that you were going to be together forever and you had all these experiences together, there's no way that 5 years down the line you could hate that person's guts and, you know, want to divorce or want to split up. That's not possible. And yet we know that it happens every single day.
You can't be a god. She fell in love with a Christian. Can't be a god.